So the area that we've come to learn that we have a huge challenge is the budget implementation. The county is still struggling with budget absorption, and it's even worrying that the sectors that are of concern to citizens, where citizens put a lot of money, they are performing so lowly, as low as below 50% absorption. In fact, the last 2 years, for example, for Baringo County, the water sector budget absorption has been between 25 and 28%. So that implies that 72% of the development budget has not been absorbed, which in the actual sense, it implies that the people have been denied the much needed service. That is the water, access to water, or in some cases, repair of boreholes have not been done, and so on and so forth.
The initial assessment that has been done of this nature, the public expenditure framework that is grades the counties under various clusters based on how they perform. Kakamega had 89% overall performance, 94% of that was on recurrent expenditure, and 79%, way lower, which could be a D, according to PEFA, PEFA assessment on development.
There's a comment cited in the Auditor General report that there was a word fund that was to be allocated 11.1 million. But at the end of the financial year, it had been allocated 40.1 million. You see, that's a huge, like almost 30 or 20 something, 29 million, that was not even planned and allocated. And basically reasons for that were not given. For the water sector that I've been analyzing, it has not been very easy to get why the deviations have been made, because you will, the budgeted money and, you know, the actual money that has been used is way, it's not really adding up. You would, like in the year 2013, 2014, there was an absorption of 233%. And then it came back to 171 the following year, and then it fell to 50% now in 2016, 2017. In 2017, 2018, it went down to 39%. Now for the recurrent expenditure. For the development, the same, from 51 to 9 point across the years. You see, that's a very big deviation percentage. But in terms of explanations, really, we cannot say why that is happening.
Kajiado is not performing well. So for the period that we are looking at, that is the period between 2014 to 2018, they have continuously been underperforming. And the reason why they have been doing this is, one, because they depend on a system that is not automated. And also this means that there could be PIFRA regis that take place because, again, you see, with the human interacting with the allocations, then you, with the revenue collection, then you can never tell.
And so for Nyeri, you'll find in those 4 years, recurrent is always high. So absorption was about 86%. But when we went to development, it was at 56% average, which is kind of just above half, which is not really well. It's not good. It's not a good performance when you're just averaging above half. And so actually, when you look at health, you find things really got bad in the year 2017-18, and not just for Nyeri County. Almost, I think Nairobi had 0% development for that year. Nyeri had around 11% 2017-18. And so, okay, the idea was that it's an election year and a few things happened here and there. But, you know, as we stuck to what is on the document, and that is the data, so you'll find development performance is actually almost going, performing downwards. So it's erratic, but going downwards. And so those are some of the issues that came out.
You know, we don't seem to be improving. Even though there is a slight improvement again, I don't think Nairobi has hit the national average performance of 80%. So because the highest between 2013 and 2014 and 2018, the highest that Nairobi has reached is 78%. So up to now, especially with development budget absorption, which I feel it is still below average. So there's so much to be done. And another thing of, you know, what could be the challenges and what can be done to be able to, in a way, bridge these gaps when it comes to budget implementation.
My general observation in terms of Busia County, general performance of the budget is not stable. It's not something that is predictable to know how it's performing. Because you realize like 2014, 2015, 2015, 2016, the general performance was better because it was above 80%. So like 2014, 2015, it was ranging something around 85%. So going to almost 90%. Then 2016, 2017, something happened. The performance went down between 60% to 50%. You realize 51%, 69%, which is again, that's the general performance of the budget. And when the budget performs decimally like that, then which is the most critical area that is affected is the development budget.